Welcome to my Texas workshop. I'm Randy Lammers.
I'm Aaron Keevan.
This is Worth Knowing. What do you do when you need an internal thread in thin metal and a removable assembly? Rivet nuts are a good option with excellent repeatability. Aaron, that's our show today, is rivet nuts.
So Randy, what are rivet nuts?
They're internal threaded inserts.
Okay.
They work very, very good in any thin metals. We see them in plastic materials. We see them in composite materials. So it's an excellent way to put an internal thread in those materials.
Yeah, exactly. It also, the elimination of tapping,
right,
welding, and using nuts and bolts even.
That's correct. And those operations can be costly.
They certainly can.
This also gives you the opportunity to install from only one side of the assembly. So you have an enclosed assembly installed from one side of the assembly.
Yeah, exactly like what we saw in blind rivets.
Exactly the same thing. And the materials are similar.
Yeah, exactly. So we have steel, aluminum, and stainless are pretty common in those. And then the finish for the steel is going to be a zinc plating.
Yeah, exactly. Giving you the ductility of that plating. Mm-hmm. So that's the basis of what they are. Aaron, you want to see how they work?
Yeah, sure do. Let's go.
Okay. All right. Let's put our safety glasses on first.
All right.
First of all, I would like to give a special shout out to Industrial Rivet, also known as Rivet King, for letting us borrow their tool today and also supplying the samples we'll be utilizing. So
yeah, thank you guys.
Thank you, gentlemen, for that. So, Aaron, this is the way it works. We have a threaded mandrel on this tool.
Okay.
And you'll notice this looks very much like a blind rivet tool.
Yeah.
This is called a spin-spin tool. So it's just spinning, and it will actually pull this up. So the way you start is you just thread that on.
Okay.
And then hold on to it, let the mandrel then go all the way into it. Now it's set.
Okay.
And it's just like putting in a blind rivet. When we did the blind rivet episode, that is put in the hole, pull the trigger, and there it is.
Oh, perfect.
So we have a very nice set on the back side, which gives you then the resistance to pull through.
Okay.
You want to try one?
Oh yeah, it's my turn. Let's
okay.
go. All right, so you said get it threaded on there.
Correct.
Couple threads.
Hold it.
Hold it. Pull the trigger.
You got it.
Got it set. Take my plate.
Mm-hmm.
Through hole and pull the trigger again. Well, looky there.
Isn't that cool?
That's awesome.
Okay, now that you've done that, you want to do some real world work? I mean, real world work?
I'm feeling you're going to get in some trouble right now.
This was my opportunity to fix a problem my wife has had with her 1993 Jeep Wrangler all of these years. Let's pull the Jeep in the shop and let's fix the top on the Jeep.
All right, let's go.
Okay. All right, Aaron, we have my wife's 1993 Jeep Wrangler, her absolutely love and pride and joy.
Yeah, I can see it has her personality.
It definitely has her personality, but we've been wanting to get this fixed for a long, long time, and the rivet nuts just gave me the perfect idea of how to fix this. So here's the problem. So she rides with the soft top on here all the time, and this is what happens. There's a track underneath here. I'll show it to you in just a second. But this comes loose.
Oh, sure.
They just use little sheet metal screws. And so what happens is this ends up blowing completely off. And here she is going down the road trying to hold this top and shift gears and stay in the right lane
What's the same shifting gears?
Shifting gears. Yeah, that's called a manual transmission.
A manual, gotcha. Okay. Okay.
So let me take this top off. And it just kind of comes unhooked and show you the track system underneath.
Okay, cool.
Okay, we have folded the top back. And Aaron, again, what we have here is an aluminum track. And you can see really how this wants to just, it comes loose. These screws my friends, are not holding very well. You're gonna see where I've tried to put some little hex head screws in here, but I wanna show you the original screw that was in here. Sure. So look, what do we have here, Aaron? It
looks like a little AB tapping screw.
That's what was in here. So these are, this is thin gauge metal. They put little AB tapping screws in here. Now, you know, it's semi-held up.
Yeah, 30 years.
There you go.
I'd say that's pretty decent. 30
years. Yeah. So you'll come around, give me a hand. We will take all of these screws out, take this track off, and then what we'll need to do is drill out these holes to the right diameter.
Sure.
And then install the threaded inserts. I'm excited about getting this done. Okay, so let's take these out. So we have drilled all of our holes for this size 1032 insert. We have a 1964 drill bit. We had to clean up some burrs on a couple of them, but we're ready to put the inserts in. So you ready for that, Aaron?
Yep, here's the first one.
And as we demonstrated earlier, we just screw it on a couple of times, hold it, pull the trigger, and it's ready to go. So we'll just do this first one real quick.
Gotcha.
All right, again, just rotate it on there. These goes in so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Aaron, thank you for helping me with that. We got that tucked back in.
Yeah.
And look, there is no play in this.
I know, it's perfect. I mean, before you could have probably taken that and just taken it all the way off.
So you think that's gonna hold up to going 80 miles an hour in the Texas highway?
I hope so.
Okay, thank you for the help. Greatly appreciate it. Aaron, thank you for helping me get that done. And my wife thanks you.
It's about time, Randy.
It's only been close to 30 years, but now we don't have to worry about that top coming off anymore. One of the things I want to mention is this plate from one of our good manufacturers, and that is to show you that these do come in different configurations. We have closed in if you need to seal off the application. They also, it's hard to see here, but they come in a hex configuration if you have high resistance to turning, and then they also come with the studs.
Yep.
So there are different configurations of these. So in conclusion, these are simple to install from one side of the workpiece.
Exactly right. It also can lower your assembly costs versus some of the other methods we've talked about in the past. Tapping operations could be eliminated with this.
Absolutely, and there's no surface preparation. So if you notice that we were able to just put that over the painted surface,
exactly.
So it can be done in your final assembly.
Yep. It's ideal for close to edge applications.
So think of this, rivet nuts are an excellent option for repeatable, reusable assemblies. Rivet nuts, internal threads, thin materials, and one side assembly. That's Worth Knowing.
You like this fastening content? Subscribe, like, and leave us a comment.